today's video, we survived 100 days in Minecraft as an axolotl. Except we're in the Ice Age. Yep, me and my friends joined a multiplayer morph SMP. And this is how it went. The goals of this video is to create the strongest nation on the server, go to war with our enemy factions, and slay the dragon in cold blood. Will we survive till the end? Watch till the end of the video to find out. Also, day one. This is where our journey begins. We spawned in a lush cave. That's normally where axolotls spawn in the first place. We took a look around the place and didn't see too many things out of the ordinary besides the cave generation. I'm not sure if it's natural, but it looks really cool. And straight off of the bat, we get attacked by a creeper. What are the chances? Well, then again, we are in a cave, so it kind of makes sense. But come on, don't do me like that. I didn't even get a single piece of wood yet and I'm getting attacked. One of the interesting challenges within this video is actually the fact that I am an axolotl, and that means I have less health. I could literally get one or two shot by skeletons. Luckily for us, I managed to knock the creeper down into the chasm below, and I started looking for a way out. Luckily, just like the last time, there was a water chute that led all the way up to the surface. Except this time, when I was expecting me to actually get some wooden tools, I ended up in a desert. This place dusty as hell. Oh, and guess what? One of the creepers, one of their boys was waiting for me at the very top, but obviously he didn't stand a chance with me. And that's just because your boy's cracked. Ain't nothing else to it. Another huge issue with this challenge is the fact that I actually freeze when I'm on ground without some sort of light source or heat source. So what I decided to do was take it to the water. I thought it would be a little better there. Upon diving in, we did find some squids, but to my surprise, there was a dolphin catching its prey. It just murdered a fish. And you know what I decided to do? I snatched it. And right before it could start biting me, I decided to just book it out of there. I was out of the waters. That's it. Days 2 to 5. Honestly, I needed a forest. We needed that progression. And lo and behold, we finally found ourselves a forest. This is what I've been looking for. Look at these trees. They're all snowed up and everything. This ice age was deadly. I didn't know how long these trees would last in this type of weather, so I just decided to take as much wood as I possibly could, enough for a whole quarantine shelter. And by that I mean 6 wood. I think I was pretty efficient with it. And I made some wooden tools. Also, I found some berries and I decided to break them. But real talk though, can we just take into consideration how sick this looks? All right, and enough of that. I then decided to leave the forest because I had enough. I need to get some stone so I can make some stone tools. And I also spotted my first bit of iron. Let's go. Except for the fact that there was a bunch of mobs in the way. I don't know why I thought this was a smart move, but what I decided to do was sand block clutch. Why did I think of that? I guess I just wanted the iron that badly. But this is when everything started going wrong, because I wasn't the only one that dropped into that crevice. All the mobs that were up there that were chasing me also decided to fall down in there with me. And to top it all off, there was also a creeper in there. Luckily, one of the creepers actually blew up all of the mobs except for like one, but there was still a spider remaining as well. And I really didn't want to get into contact with that because I had 1.5 hearts. I just mined into the wall. Okay, that's what I had to do it. All right, I had to. I wasn't gonna stay there any longer. I just decided to book it. I didn't even get the 3 stone that I needed, bro. I have 2 cobblestone. That spider got me messed up. I decided to keep moving forward. There were a lot of cool biomes that I wanted to explore because everything looks so different. I found a bit of a cliffside and I was near the bottom of it, so I decided to mine some stone from there. Then I decided to make some stone tools, you know, obviously to protect myself and mine. I should have done this like ages ago. Days 6 to 15. In this duration of time, I actually found myself at a bit of a forest fire. That kind of confused me because the place was supposed to be freezing over. It was also raining a bit, which was kind of weird. Some wacky stuff going on with this world. But it got me thinking because I did in fact need a bit of a heat source to actually stay alive. So when I saw the tree burning, I was thinking, wait, what if I burn some wood to make charcoal and I use that charcoal to make torches? Big brain. And that's exactly what I did. This way I wouldn't freeze over to death. And without wasting any time, I was back again in the waters killing off some fish because your boy needed some more food. You know how it is. But look at the axolotl animation. That thing's clean. Anyways, I was back to exploring. One thing I did want to find is a bit of a structure because there were some custom structures around the world that I wanted to explore. But the first thing that we ran by was a village, actually. But it didn't take very long before I realized that I wasn't actually alone in this village. It seemed a little weird that some of the stuff was looted, but I didn't really take too much mind into it. But it did feel kind of off. The vibes that this village was giving me were really not it. It is only when I finally decided to go back into the blacksmith, I realized that there were 2 others that were in the village with. But to my relief, they were part of my species. I was really worried for a second because if it was something hostile, I basically had nothing. They were actually surprisingly friendly and we decided that we'd try killing the ender dragon together. We weren't gonna stick together at all times since we kind of had a little bit of a different agenda, but once we do finally settle down, we wanted to make a base together. It would be the perfect axolotl utopia, or so we thought. There was this one villager and he was kind of looking at us funny, so we all decided to attack him. Get out of here. If you're not an axolotl, you don't belong here. This part of town, it's ours now. now, okay? Us axolotls, we run this. At this time, I also decided to take it to the waters because I needed a bit more iron. I'm not sure why I found some iron underneath the water, but I wasn't really complaining about it. Look at these 1.17 iron textures. Disgusting. Anyways, we missed a golem, so I decided to kill it. Listen, okay, your boy needed iron. But this is when the trouble kind of started, and this is where it all began. I don't know which one of them actually did it, but one of the axolotls decided to swoop in, take my iron, and just book it. I chased him down, but eventually he hit the waters, and I didn't see it work. But oh my gosh, was I annoyed at that thing. Ah, you think we're playing games here, huh? Wait till I find out which one of the axolotls took it. You'll see. I will make sure they regret it. Day 16 to 25. For you guys' convenience sake, because it's kind of a repetitive clip, I decided to also cut out every single time I jumped into water or searched for it, because I do need water to survive. But in this duration of time, I also got attacked by a bunch of zombies, but luckily I took care of them. And there I was, right beside a cliffside. I thought it was nothing special, but upon further looking into it, some of the blocks were actually just super unnatural, and I was a little confused about it. We decided to tower up and eventually find ourselves at this structure. Now, this thing was massive. We definitely need to break into here and check out what kind of loot stored in this. Instead of using the front door, I decided to break a block in the back. That's because I could actually fit into small crevices, so that's kind of the perk of being an axolotl. I scurried inside and took all of the iron that I could possibly find within the chest, all while being attacked by a Drake. It gave me no remorse, it just kept attacking. So right afterwards, I just booked it to the ocean again. You can't catch me, I'm cooking my feet. Now, I didn't actually know if there were any better chests either underneath the structure or on the top of it, but honestly, I wasn't gonna risk it. Again, I only have one life and very limited hearts, so I just moved on from it. I was still continuously exploring, but I definitely wanted to find this one underwater structure that I was searching for this entire time. Now, this thing is crazy, believe me. The loot in this thing is insane. But before we head out over there, I also wanted to make a bit of a campsite. I'm not sure why, I just wanted to be an axolotl by a campfire. And I wanted to cook some of my food and I didn't want to take out the furnace. So this is what it looks like. Around the time when it became morning, I decided to finally head off into the gigantic ocean that we were right next to. And there it is. This is, ladies and gentlemen, what I like to call an abandoned pirate ship. Sight, there was so many mobs in there. It was not abandoned. That was the one thing it wasn't. I don't even know why I said that. But one thing I did utilize when I got a little bit closer to the pirate ship was the fact that I can actually fit in the most smallest of crevices. Like, look at this. They can't even see me because of how small the crevice is. Your boy was going in their international super spy mode. I was taking things out of every single chest, barrel, anything I could find. Look at these goodies. It's crazy. But I soon realized that there was a bunch of stuff in there, and I definitely need to loot the place. But that wasn't even the crazy loot yet. That was just the minor merchandise that they'd be selling in port. My plan was very simple and very straightforward. I just planted a bunch of torches around. That way the mobs won't be able to respawn based off of the spawners. And it worked for the first floor. I decided to explore that place. It wasn't much. And then I realized that there was a bottom floor, and the bottom floor had most of the valuables and goods. The issue was, the bottom of the ship was surrounded by mobs. This was evil. This was so chaotic just to get into the back room and collect the stuff from there. I didn't even know if that stuff was worth it. I decided to place some torches, go back up, and wait for a lot of them to despawn. Not to mention, I also decided to come back down and they were still spawning. Like, what? I lit the whole place up. So I finally managed to make it into the first room. I decided to block it off and take some of the loot in here. Okay, we got us some iron, some diamonds. I messed with that. All in all, the mission was successful. We successfully infiltrated and looted a pirate ship. Successfully, by the way, as an axolotl. I should get paid by the villagers that get attacked by these pirates. My god, this stuff ain't easy. Days 26 to 35. I continued going in the path of the ocean that I actually took and eventually found a bit of land. Within that bit of land, I also found myself a lighthouse. Now, this isn't your ordinary lighthouse. No, this lighthouse is a battle tower. Now, if you guys know anything about battle towers, the loot goes from top to bottom. Firstly, being really eh loot, and then it goes all the way up to some god tier loot. So I was excited for this. So we tried it, you know? Instead of actually fighting the mobs and taking it, you know, layer by layer, I decided to just walk in there, take the chest, and just book it to the next floor. The thing that I didn't take into consideration was each time I gained a floor, there was a little bit of a trickier way up there. And eventually, I got poison on one of the floors for some reason. And that led me to having to go through the extreme of breaking and jumping out of a window on a lighthouse. How the heck did my life come to this? But you can't even lie, that was a clean escape. We were out of there. You know what? I wasn't even gonna risk it, bro. I didn't want to end the video. I've gotten plenty of days done, and I honestly just wanted to continue the challenge. So I decided to just leave that be. You know, we have plenty of stuff. Just to ensure that I wouldn't die, I also had to eat a golden apple. But hey, listen, okay? I didn't want to die. I didn't want to, you know, lose the one life that I had. So your boy had to make some challenging choices. And either way, I got a couple of them, so it's fine. Days 36 to 45. On my way exploring, I actually found out that one of my axolotl friends was actually nearby. Now, Now, was he the person that took my iron? I don't know. I really can't tell them apart. But listen, okay? I was an ally. I was gonna meet up with them because they didn't mean any harm. So they're safe for now. But listen, okay? This axolotl is devious. I'm not even joking. See this guy? He had an all-out war plan. Now, I don't even know why I was even entering the war, but he said he needed some backup. So, you know, obviously, I had to help out being the nice person I am. So I'm like, all right, let's see. What do we got to work with? He seemed to have stumbled on a pillager base. And now this thing was hella decked out. Like, there were tons of pillagers inside. I was not ready to get mauled by them, honestly. But apparently, he had a bit of a plan. But just to make sure that none of us die, because if we do get banned off of the server, we needed one more backup. We got the third axolotl friend of ours. This was it. I don't even know why we're attacking them. But listen, okay, they probably did something to my friend. And if someone hurts one of the axolotls, you know damn well the rest of us axolotls were gonna be backing him up. No questions asked. This was Operation Pillager. The premise of this operation is very, very simple. We needed to destroy that thing. Apparently, it also goes around attacking random villages, and they even needed our help for that. So one of the axolotls actually planted a bunch of TNT surrounding the place. But not only that, but we also wanted to get some of the loot from there. So we were going to infiltrate this facility without being killed. And right when we were about to exit, we will also blow this place to smithereens. And that was the plan. One thing we didn't take into account, though, is the fact that a pillager came up to us and actually questioned us as to what we were doing nearby the pillager base. Uh-oh, we might have just gotten caught. Yeah, as if we were gonna let that happen. We decided to just straight up attack him and kill him off. That way, he also wouldn't be able to alert his pillager friends when he gets back in. Now, just like the last time I actually decided to siege into a place, a pirate ship, we decided to go in through a crevice once again. That way, we can go in undetected, but once we do get detected, we are fully ready to go in full force. Got our shields up, our weapons up. We are built for this. And so, the siege began. We were finally in. We decided to take some hay bales. We also looked around the chests and stuff, some pretty good loot. In all honesty, the place looked a lot bigger from the outside. Within the inner walls, it actually wasn't that big. Now, the one question remained, where were all the pillagers? Because literally, when the last axolotl decided to scout out the place, there were tons of pillagers just roaming about. But where did they all go? To our surprise, we actually found out that they were having a bit of a meeting in one of their main hall rooms. Now, we didn't know it was a main hall room, but we heard a little bit of noise coming from there. We decided to open the doors, and lo and behold, an army of pillagers started chasing after the three of us. We ran as fast as we could. Instantly, when we left the place, we also decided to hit that button so that the explosives would go off on them. I was in the water at this time, just in case any of the TNT started flinging my way, but luckily, none of it did, and they were done. They were taken care of. We further inspected the place just to make sure there weren't any survivors, because if we kept them alive, they would have came after us, and we didn't need word spreading about this. Honestly, the server was already hostile as it is. There's so much griefing involved with the server. It's ridiculous. We definitely didn't want them knowing that a bunch of axolotls got into their base. And yeah, there were some stragglers, but we decided to kill them off. Very, very aggressive. Do I regret it? Maybe. Would I do it again? Perhaps. You never know. Only time will tell. From there on, we also decided to split paths once again because we were all working on our separate projects. Me, on the other hand, I was working on exploring all of these cool new structures. So one of the ones that I actually found was a villager trading facility. This thing is like Amazon, but for villagers. It's crazy. But I swear they didn't want to talk to me. It's probably because I'm an axolotl. It makes sense, you know? I see how it is. I didn't want your company anyway, dummy. I also decided to climb to the very top and look at the chests, but they had nothing. They all hoarded all of their stuff within their shops and pockets. It's crazy. How'd they even carry all that stuff? I kept exploring for a while and didn't actually find much. So eventually I just decided, you know what? Let's take a mining trip. I dug straight down and eventually I found myself in this little cavern. There was a bunch of dripstone. Not to mention there was water and a bit of a mine shaft, I think. I don't even know what to call these things, but I did manage to hay bale clutch, so that's kind of cool. I'm telling you, bro, your boy's cracked. Anyways, we did some exploring. I found the mine shaft that it was connected to. I also found some lava, which I bridged over, but luckily it actually did help out with just keeping me warm throughout the winter. That led onto more caves, and just look at these things. These are crazy. They're actually just straight up cave biomes. I started building up because I saw this really cool looking thing. It ended up being this massive cave structure thing. I don't know what to call this thing. Honestly, I really don't, but this thing was ginormous. I found a chest in here too with a spawner. Days 46 to 50. I found another chest, but after that chest, I didn't really have much luck. I wasn't sure what I was looking for, but if I definitely came across diamonds, I'd mine them up. But anyways, after a long mining trip, I finally decided it was time to see some grass. And that's what your boy did. We started placing some blocks, you know, going upwards. We were in a bit of a jungle biome. And to my surprise, I actually found a different axolotl. They were showing off of their horse, even though they kind of looked goofy riding it because they were kind of just leaning off of the side. But they were honestly super chill about it. They even let me ride the horse. Like, look at this thing. We were also exchanging some goods. He gave me two amethysts and I gave him two diamonds in return.
return.
I don't know why I was so generous with it, honestly. I needed all the diamonds I can get. But hey, listen, okay, you win some, you lose some. But obviously, we were on two different paths. We were doing something completely different. So we went our separate ways. It was nice meeting you, though. I also found this really cool mixture between a dark oak forest and mushrooms. It was a little bit peculiar at first, but it kind of grew on me. I also found this thing that kind of looked like an altar in that forest. It was really weird. Days 51 to 65. Now, despite how far we actually ran out, we decided to go back to the original place that it all started in, the lush cave that we spawned in. And when I say we, I mean all three of us axolotls. That was kind of like the meeting point. We also wanted to build some bases over there. After a long journey of going over there, I also decided to make a bunch of shovels just so I can shovel up a bunch of sand. This was actually for my base, and I needed a bunch of glass for it. I also needed a bunch of wood, so I got some of that as well. But alas, we were finally ready to head back into the cave. I was prepared for this, you know, it was first come, first serve, so I decided to make my leap for it. I wanted to pick out a spot where I could build my base. I was preferably looking for a flat spot, that way it would be much easier to work on what I was working on. Now trust me, this idea of mine is pretty sick. So we have a house, right? And that house would be inside of a globe. I like to call this creation of mine the house in a globe. Yeah, that sounds sick. But this was it. This was the spot that I decided to pick. Now I didn't really know how I was gonna build it, and I honestly just started placing some blocks, and I was like, all right, let me use this as a bit of groundwork. And this is what it ended up looking like. I thought it was pretty cool. I still wanted to add a little bit of a second floor on the left side, but hey, you know, we'll do that in a bit. I placed down the orange bed, and look at this place. This place looks amazing. I also decided to smelt some of my iron real quick. Now this was it. This was the house we were going to work with. Now we just need to fill it up with a sphere. So we got to work. I started smelting all of the sand that I had so I can make it into glass. It definitely took a while, but with my last axolotl video, I'm kind of used to making these spheres now. I can officially say that I'm a bit of a sphere professional, if I do say so myself. And just when I was about to be finished with the sphere, one of the axolotls that lived in the lush cave decided to come to my base. There was around four creepers over there. Now, when I tell you there was a tremendous amount of creepers, I mean it. Like, these things would not stop spawning. Ever since the beginning of this series, we had so much gunpowder, it was unreal. We could probably make explosives for any seed. At this point, just make the axolotls a world power. What are you doing, server? Get to it. But anyways, he decided to take those creepers and explode the front of my house for some reason. I listen, okay? We wasn't gonna play no more games anymore, alright? This is every man for themselves. I mean, every axolotl for themselves. I chased him down back to his base, and I decided to hit them. Again, we were really against the concept of actually killing each other because we'd get banned, and we were kind of at that truce. But griefing my base? Come on, bro. But eventually, I did manage to negotiate him into helping me rebuild my house, but it ended up not being as helpful, but more of a detriment. So I was just like, you know what? I'll take care of you. Just go back to your little house. What a gremlin. Day 66 to 70. I also decided to go mining around the place because I thought there might be some diamonds. Remember those pillagers? The pillagers that we killed off in that explosion during the siege of their base? Yeah, well, it seems like there was a survivor. They kind of followed us back to the base, except we didn't know about it. We don't know who or which one of us they were following, but it led them right to our base. And by the way, we all lived right next to each other. So if one of our houses gets messed up, I'm pretty sure all of ours do. I was on my way back to my house after looking around for some diamonds. I didn't have much luck because I actually didn't realize what Y level we were at. I don't think we were even at diamond Y level. That was kind of dumb of me. But to my surprise, I found a huge hole or gap in the dome, and there was a pillager just standing there with an enchanted bow. And before I knew it, they took the flame bow shot and lit my house into smithereens. All of the materials that that base took, all of the hard work and the amount of structuring that I put into that base was just all taken away from me in one fell swoop. The explosives was damaging the entire cave. Like, the entire system was being attacked by these huge, gigantic blocks of TNT flying around everywhere. I had to put in my shield just so I don't die. I also managed to slip into some water, luckily. Although I managed to conserve one of the lives that I had on this server, I couldn't conserve the base. There was all of our hard work just gone, blown up, torn to pieces, all because of that one raid that we did. This was a really devastating moment for all of the axolotls because everyone in that cave was affected. That cave was no longer a safe haven. We, from that day on, just became nomads. Having a base just meant that we had a big weakness and a huge burden on our shoulders, so we just ignored it. After comprehending this situation, we decided to take what any person would do as the next step to their journey. And this is simply because of the fact that one of the goals was, in fact, to kill off the Ender Dragon. But don't worry, we didn't forget that we need to get revenge on these pillagers once and for all. I decided to use the water bucket strat on the lava and decided to make myself the full portal. The issue was we didn't have anything to light it with, so I had to go get some flint and steel. But once I got back, I decided to light the portal and we were in. We were in the Nether. Now, surprisingly, I didn't feel as endangered as I should have been, but that's probably because the pillagers were all in the overworld. We had found a temporary escape. This was definitely a weird sight, because not only was it the Arctic up there, but it was also the Arctic in the Nether. Just look at this place. It looks so weird. But this was an interesting mixture. The last time I came into the Nether as an axolotl, I got stuffed into a bucket. This time around, it was actually fine because water was allowed in the Nether. It's just a simple concept of snow melting into water. And added onto that, not only are we able to survive in the Nether like that, we also get heat from the lava sources and the fire sources within the Nether. So it was honestly a lot more safer to be out there than in the overworld. Isn't that insane? Shortly after exploring a bit, I also found myself at a bit of a red biome. I did have a couple questions though. I was wondering if Bastion spawned. We honestly just went in a direction and decided to just go that way. Eventually we'll hit something. Day 71 to 80. And there it is. That's the Nether castle for you. It was just out in the open. I'm just glad it's not buried underneath the ground, because if that was the case, then we would have been there for a while. And so we decided to scale the place and attack the blazes. As you can already guess, your boy was gonna get all of the blazes that we needed. Why did I want to get the blaze rod so quickly? This is why, because one of the axolotls came back and broke it. So we had to find another spawner and get the rest of them. Next up on the agenda was actually a bastion. Now this wasn't too far away from the Nether castle. The reason we needed one of these was actually for two things. One, arrows, so we could actually shoot down the towers. And two, ender pearls. We needed plenty of them so we can make some eye of enders and get to the end, so we can kill the ender dragon. So we went straight to work. Eventually, I found myself at the bastion floor, and I decided to start bridging up, but I kind of failed a little bit. But eventually, we got up. All of the gold on this bastion, well, most of it at least, was on the bridge, so it was super easy to collect. But I didn't just stop there, because a lot of the chests were already looted in the place, just not the gold. So instead, I decided to go to a second bastion after traveling a bunch. Now, this bastion was a little bit more deadly, because we found a bunch of brutes. Now, if you guys don't know, brutes could quite literally just like two or one tap us. They do crazy amounts of damage and armor does not matter to them. Luckily, for some reason, they seemed very distracted. I wasn't actually sure why. My guess is its attention was actually on one of the other axolotls. And so I just ran in there, took the fortune pickaxe, and I ran for my life. But I didn't go too far because there was also the second section. I looted the middle chest and it didn't really have anything of that much value, but it was still pretty cool. I used a little bit of a trick to lure a bunch of piglins to me and put them in a hole so they could actually trade. This way I can get the pearls and the spectral arrows that I needed to kill the ender dragon with. Look at these goofy looking piglins. Little do they know, they are doing my dirty work. I don't need to go to the blue biome and get myself some ender pearls. I don't need to do any of that. All I needed was the blaze powder and the gold that they provided me from their own bastion. But hey, you know, I was pretty grateful for it. They gave me a lot of cool stuff and a bunch of random stuff. I don't know why some of these trades even exist. But listen, okay, I was pretty happy about this. This actually gave me a lot of ender pearls, above the amount I even needed. Now at this time, I'm not actually sure what the other two were doing, but I was heading my way back to the Nether portal. Upon going there, I actually found another axolotl that was AFK. Should I have killed him? Why would you guys even think that? What the heck? No. I just went back through the portal. Days 81 to 90. I also got reminded exactly what had happened to my base. And luckily for us, one of our axolotl friends actually helped us out and gave us a little bit of information as to where we could find the primary base, to where the pillager that destroyed my house actually lived at. This was gonna be fun. I wasted no time whatsoever. This is the beginning of Operation Pillager War. So here was the plan. Yeah, we could have blown up the base, but this one was a bit tricky because there were three pillager outposts, one after another, and that was a bit of a problem because they had security checks. We did have a bunch of gunpowder and we could have made a bunch of TNT, but that wasn't the way to go. What me and my friends decided to do was us as axolotls, we're gonna burn that place to the ground. But not only that, we were also going to massacre whoever was there and make sure this time that there were zero survivors. I quickly crafted a boat and went over there straight away. We crossed the ocean, but after the ocean, we ended up at a bit of a red desert. I started crossing that on land. Even though I could have taken the waters, I just wanted to take the land for some reason. During this period of time, I also decided to make myself some diamond armor for the fight. I was not going to lose, not to mention we had 4 golden apples. I was going to be ready when it came time to take action. Finally, we reached the end of that silly biome, and honestly, I was so relieved to finally see trees again. They didn't die. They still exist. Ignoring my tree-deprived self, we still kept going. Eventually, it did come to an end though, but I did manage to get some acacia wood out of it. I decided to place my boat and go back into the waters, where I don't actually have to keep going back and forth between the two. I hit another body of land that was filled with red sand just like the last time, but instead this time around, I decided to place down an anvil so I can put some sharpness onto my axe. Now this thing was gonna help out a ton, especially with the Ender Dragon fight and the war that's to come. This was no joke, okay? We were about to get into this fight, no regrets, no remorse. I met up with my two axolotl friends, and we scurried over to a nearby village. This village was actually being attacked by these pillager outposts and the pillagers within them, so we need to step in, obviously, but I'm kind of in it for the revenge, to be honest. But hey, saving the village is a plus. And there it was. The war had already begun. Some of the axolotls are already going out of their way to killing some of these pillagers. Their houses are literally burning down as we speak. Lava was spilled on the ground. Unluckily for me, I actually got attacked by a whole bunch of them, and nobody was really near me at that time, so I just had to book it. I was super low, and I managed to dig into the ground and block myself in. At that very moment, that literally could have been the end of the series. Ain't no way I was gonna let that happen. We dug ourselves out and continued the destruction. Their bases were devastated. The amount of arson that we did to their bases was unreal. All of the pillagers, for the most part, were completely demolished. Just by looking at these structures, you can tell that there's not a single glimpse of life left in them. Next time, the pillagers will think twice before taking down one of our houses and even considering messing with us. Days 91 to 100. I'm actually super happy we even got our revenge. I was starting to think we would never get that revenge because we couldn't locate their base. But luckily, one of our axolotl friends were actually on it. All that's remaining is the Ender Dragon fight. And finally, bringing back the valuable items from the end and placing it down and where we all began, the lush cave of ours. So we decided to continue our journey, right? Because I had Eye of Enders and I decided to chuck one into the air and see where it landed us, as we're kind of supposed to do. That's how Eye of Enders work. But finally, the Eye of Ender went downwards and we didn't waste any time mining down. A little bit of an issue was the fact that I got mauled by zombies the first second I entered the stronghold. It was ridiculous. And obviously the fact that I had less than average health kind of made it a very difficult situation. We were in this stronghold for quite a bit, but eventually I managed to find myself at the library. This is where I got a bunch of string because I needed a bow. I was going to make sure that these arrows came into some use. And this is exactly how I was going to do that. And I had finally arrived at the portal. The other two axolotl friends of mine have already found it and they were just waiting on me, really. That's where I decided to sit down, craft up my bow, and we were ready. We were ready to enter the end, kill off the Ender Dragon, and collect its valuables. I started placing all of the Eye of Enders that I actually owned, and it turns out that one of the axolotls there is a complete nuisance. Honestly, they pushed me off and I was, okay, whatever. I went back up, placed the Eye of Ender, and decided it was time to enter the end. And there we were. As you can see, that was just a dragon flying by. And another moment where one of the axolotls were a complete nuisance. Anyways, we decided to go up and actually start getting some of the towers. This is also a compilation of me being very good at, you know, shooting down some of these crystals. You can just call me, you know, Phase Adrian. So I think that's a good title. Now, despite the beds in my inventory, we just completely shot down the dragon. Like, we did not let it perch. We didn't even let it breathe for a second without being shot at by these pointy arrows. We brought it down to a super low amount and we honestly wanted to melee hit it as the final clip of the video. That would have been the perfect way to end off the Ender Dragon because we were super close anyways, you know? Shooting it with a bow was kind of pointless. Miles. But yeah, one of the axolotls decided to shoot before it actually landed and we could hit it ourselves, which was kind of whack, which is pretty lame. But, you know, we can't do anything about it. But wait, it didn't just end there, because we still need to bring back some of the valuables and put it on a podium at where it all began. This was in honor of all the bases that were destroyed by the pillagers of this world. Obviously, we collected the Ender Dragon egg, but what I was more focused on was the Elytra and the Dragon Head. So eventually, after traveling across quite a bit, actually, I finally managed to find myself one of the end cities, decided to scale it, and got the Elytra from the ship. I went back to the dragon egg portal and decided to jump into it. It was over, all right? We got the stuff we needed. We hopped back into the world, and look, we spawned right back at where we needed to be. We went down and finally placed everything we needed. We placed down the dragon egg right onto the podium, and Miles right-clicked it and got it stuck underneath the bedrock. Bye.